here on today's show. Thank you for supporting the Mustang Players, and please enjoy our production of Mamma Mia!
did in the olden days.
Her whole life ahead of her.
Mom, I'm getting married. He's from Jersey.
My name's Eddie.
Bonjour, madame.
Let's do that.
in the Archimonger Swamps.
Oh, yes, I read your book. A bloke
in a boat in Botswana.
Oh, thanks, Harry. I heard I'd sold a copy somewhere.
Oh, yes, travel books are my passion. A welcome distraction from the tedious trek to work.
You want to hear something really interesting? See this, Taverna?
Oh, I'm rather impressed. I remember an old hut being here. I was dreading bedding down with the goats.
Give me goats before camels. There was this one time in the Kalahari, the sun was beating down.
Sorry to interrupt you, Indiana, but the point is, this is my Taverna. I built it, or I designed it. I drew up the plans, what, 21 years ago? God, I can't believe that she's actually come and built the thing.
Who?
Donna, who else? This is something that I scribbled on the back of a menu. I had no idea.
You know it's yours.
Well, buildings are like babies. You always know your own.
I wouldn't know anything about babies. I've been living out of a rucksack for most of my life.
The happy wonder, huh?
Do you think the island will inspire some prose?
I sure hope so. When I received my wedding invite, I was currently selling my editor on a piece called Childhood Haunts Revisited.
You were born here?
No. I was born and raised in the Bethnal Green, not my mother's green. No, the last time I came to Greece was to visit my great aunt out on the mainland, and that was about 21 years ago.
So, now you can write about Sam Taverna and all the tourists who flock.
No, I think this island should remain the secret idol I always remembered.
But if you were born here, maybe that idol would be boatloads of tourists with pockets full of money.
At least there'd be some staff then. Where is everybody?
Hello, can I help you?
Hello, I'm Bill Austin. Do you have a room for me?
Bill Austin?
I'm Bright. Harry Bright.
Harry? Oh my goodness, so you must be...
Sam Carmichael. You're expecting us?
Yes, of course. I'll run and go get your keys. Yes!
Charming. But I was hoping to get my tongue wrapped around a little Greek. I haven't spoken it in what, 21 years?
21 years, huh? You know, this is actually starting to feel like some kind of setup. Bill, here's a story for you. Three men, strangers, are invited to a wedding. They're invited to an island that they haven't been to for 21 years by a woman that they haven't seen for 21 years. Why are they here?
All right, that's not bad. Here, what's your story? What's drawn you away from the Bank of England?
Is this an interview? Well, for me, Donna's invitation brought back many happy memories.
Oh, bloody Nora! Is that a quote?
No, no, I know this guitar! HD! Headbanger! That's what they used to call me! Early DS Donna Sheridan! I bought this for her! 10 quid in a Johnny Rotten t-shirt! Oh, and who says I'm an old stick in the mud now?
Who says that?
Oh, my other half. Big house, fast car, season tickets to Chelsea football. It's not enough for some people, is it? No, they want the great white hunter too. Well, I can do spontaneity. Donna knew my wild side. That's why I'm here. I was on a sixth form trip to Paris when we met, and I just followed her to Greece. Yeah.
Songs I'm singing.
We used to sing this one.
Thanks for all the joy there.
Your daughter's daughter?
Yes.
Oh, never.
I
because she's always talking about her friends from the olden days, and I thought she'd just be thrilled to find writing you all, but she's got herself into such a state about this wedding. You mentioned I expect guests, and she'll hyperventilate.
Hold on, Sophie. Are you trying to tell me that Donna didn't invite her guests?
No, but I can fix this if you just listen to me.
You don't understand.
Mother says I wasn't.
So if you're really the one who sent the invitations, then I'm still barred.
No, that was years ago. I want you here.
Why?
Because I just want everyone to be friends.
Oh, you're worse than your mother. I'm glad you haven't met my boys. You'd ruin them.
Your boys? You have sons?
Yeah, I've got two. God, I'd love to bring them here someday.
Just like you used to bring my mom.
Sometimes you like me to pinch you?
You keep your hands to yourself!
You've changed your tune.
What the hell are you doing here, Sam? What are any of you doing here? I'm sorry, I'm just so amazed to see you all.
Well, I'm doing an article for a magazine.
And I'm here on a holiday.
I thought that I'd just stop by and say hi.
Oh dear, what a shame. We don't have any rooms available. It is that time of year.
Just as well I booked ahead. You two can bunk with me if they're really full.
This is so inconvenient.
Why?
Because one of the local girls is getting married tomorrow and I just don't have the staff to cope with you. You'd be so much more comfortable out on the mainland.
Not at all. Phil's used to suffering for his art, and headbanger Harry hears the last word in spontaneous.
What about him?
No. I came to see the island. You know what it meant to me.
Well, I'll just stop and show up a full time. I have to go and clean up my handbag or something.
Age and not wither.
I was expecting a rather stout patron.
No, she's still done.
Just one loving I can hear a bell ring. One more loving I forget everything. Oh, mamma mia, here I go again. My, how can I resist ya? Mamma mia, does it show again? My, just how much I missed ya. There's a broken hearted, losing the day being parted. Why, did I ever let you go?
Nothing! Leave me alone! I can't talk about
some jerk.
Typical man.
You see, I'm not really sure if it was him. There were a couple of other...
Donna Sheridan, you dark horse!
Why didn't you tell us?
I didn't think I'd ever have to. I didn't think they'd be all three be sitting in my bar the day before their daughter's wedding.
What bar?
Let them see you.
I can't see anyone. Who are they?
Donna, are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. You think I would forget my daughter's dads? It's Sam. Every headbanger.
Not!
God, why have they all turned up now? It's like some horrible trick of fate.
I mean, it is very Greek.
Do they know?
Of course they don't know. I've never told anyone. Why are they here to ruin Sophie's wedding?
I thought you were keen on this wedding.
I don't want them spoiling it. They have no right to turn up like this. Day ever done for their daughter.
Donna, be fair. They didn't even know she existed.
And they don't need to. I've done a great job with soap all by myself, and now I'm going to be muscled out by an ejaculation.
No, you're not. Stay calm. It's a man out of the hen zone. And tomorrow, Tanya and I will take you fishing.
Fishing? Oh, no, that takes me back.
Donna, why didn't you tell us? You know, I remember Bill Austin. He was a bit of all right.
I suppose it's a laugh and a memory for you too, but I was the one who got pregnant. I suppose this just about serves me right.
Oh, my God, you sound just like your mother!
I do not!
Oh, yes, you do! Whatever happened to my Donna, life and soul of the party, El Ratchet Supremo?
I grew up as all.
Oh, we'll grow back down again. You've done nothing to be ashamed of.
Yeah!
Screw it, I can't take a joke!
clean his handcuffs.
Don't go.
What? I miss out on my last night of freedom.
I don't mean don't go. I mean, is that how you really see it?
I see it as the last night for the biggest adventure of my life. Come here.
You know how I said that I wanted to find my dad?
Sophie, we've been over this 1,000 times. You don't need your dad. I'm here.
Yeah. Sky, whatever happens, you'll never leave me, will you?
Are you crazy? You turn my world upside down.
I was a jealous with the weakness. Now every man that I see is all for the everything is you. And all I
only the summer night of our next proud to present the world's first girl power band live before you in all its grown-up wrinkly glory.
Speak for yourself, Tanya.
One night, one number, that's all we've got the breath for. Give it up for Donna and the Dynamo!
Are gonna blind me, but I won't feel blue.
a one-off. Well, we talked and we fought. You know, it was me who brought her to the island.
That was the only thing you did now, was it?
Okay, what has she told you?
Nothing. I don't think she's ever mentioned your name.
Well, you said Mom's always talking about her friends from the old days. What's going on? Sophie? But why am I here?
Your smile and the sound of your voice.
think so.
No, what comes next?
Oh God, don't tell me you have a twin sister!
No. Will you give me away tomorrow?
Give you away?
I'll feel like a proper bride when I walk down the aisle with my father.
I'll go talk to your mother.
Oh no, let's just keep this our secret till the wedding.
She'll go crazy.
She'll see that we're happy. She'll be relieved.
All right, I'll do it.
Here we go.
were down with the measles, and I couldn't do your time
scale. Get off! I'm not a baby!
I know, but you're still my daughter, Sophie, and you know that something's wrong. It can't be stopped.
It isn't too late. I can sort out this wedding malarkey.
Malarkey?
What do you mean, malarkey?
Nothing. I'm sorry. It's just a figure of speech.
No, it's not. That's what you really think, isn't it? That I'm stupid to get married? That it's just a whim?
I'm not pretending. I really understand.
Of course you don't. You did just fine without a man. You never dated the marriage and the babies thing. You just did the babies. Well, good for you.
Hang on. What's happening? Why are you having a go at me?
I'm going to do it right now. I love Sky, and I want to be with him. And I don't want my children growing up not knowing who their dad is, because let me tell you, it's bad.
Sophie!
Now I wish I understood. It used to be so nice, it used to be so
Don't listen to him, Tanya. He's all talk. What's happened?
It's a mess, and it's just all my fault. I know I shouldn't have, but I read Mom's diary, and I've got three possible dads.
What?
I invited them to the wedding, thinking that I know who my father was straight away, but I
didn't.
Now all three think they're my dad, and all three expect me to give me away tomorrow.
Go back. You did what?
I invited my dads to our wedding. It was 3 months ago. I wasn't even sure that they'd all show up.
3 months?
Sky, you've got to help me.
Why didn't you tell me?
Because I just knew you wouldn't like it.
I thought we talked about everything. I thought we had trust, but you wouldn't get on my back with some stranger?
No, it wasn't like that.
Is that what this big white wedding's for? A setup so you can find your dad?
No, it's not that.
I just wanted to take a boat to the mainland. Just get married with a couple witnesses. But you insisted on having this fantasy wedding all so you can make happy families?
It's knowing who I am. I want to get married knowing who I am.
That doesn't come from knowing your dad, so it comes from you. How would you feel if I lied to you? I was marrying you because I loved you. And I thought that's what you wanted, but I just don't know.
You don't know if you love me?
I don't know if it's what you really want.
I'm sorry I'm interrupting.
No. Listen, you think about it.
Scott, no, please wait!
Why not?
Nothing, excuse me!
Let him go, he's right. You have to be sure of what you really want.
It's got nothing to do with you.
Look, I can't give you away unless I know that you're really happy.
Listen, I've had this conversation already with my mother, and she knows me a lot better than you do.
What does Donna the Dynamo know about marriage? Or divorce. Look, I've got 20 years of good experience to fit into just 2 minutes, so hear me out. You're so young, you have your whole life ahead of you. But I've been there, so I've done the whole big white wedding and the cake and... Well, I'm sorry, but it doesn't always end up happy ever after. I can still remember pleading with my wife.
Did you feel that way when you got married?
can't get my hat right. Can't get anything right. Come in.
Donna.
Harry, what are you doing here?
What did I give you this?
I don't mean you're here. I mean here on this island.
Please.
Bloody Nora, what is this?
Thought you must have had to tighten your belt a little bit over the years. Taking care of Sophie on your own? Wanted to contribute a little something towards the wedding?
This would cover four weddings and a funeral. Oh, Harry, it's a lovely gesture, but...
Do you remember the last time you said that to me?
No.
It's when I bought you the guitar. I remember thinking, these will be the last words I'll ever hear from Donna Sheridan, and I will cherish them forever.
Oh, Harry, it's a wonderful gesture, Walter. You made that up. I'm sure I just said thank you nicely, like a well-brought-up Catholic girl.
That is so much better. You know, that's the first time I've heard you laugh since I first arrived on the island.
I'm a bit stressed, Harry. What do you expect?
A bit more of your Donna. A little bit less of the stressed out mother of the bride.
Thank you.
Sophie tells me that you're giving her away.
Yes, I am. Who else?
Well, how about her dad?
Her dad isn't here.
It's what she wants. She told me. She wants her father to be there. Well, maybe her father wants that too.
What? Don't do this now, Sam. I don't want to do this right now.
Anna, listen. This is about us.
I don't want to talk.
More to say, no more history.
Rosie?
Go in with the others till I finish.
It's a note. I got it from Sophie. She wanted me to walk her down the aisle, but now she's changed her mind? I'm so confused. I don't know who I am. I don't know where I am. I just came here for a wedding. I'm Sophie's dad.
Whoa. You need to have a conversation with Donna.
Yes, I will talk to her.
No. You will do no such thing. Sophie is getting married in 5 minutes. Now take a pew and butt.
Is it even all right for me to be here?
For God's sakes, Bill.
Well, to tell you the truth, I was really dreading to walk down that aisle. You know, I may come across as an intrepid traveler, but I'm all wobbly at the thought of a wedding.
Tell me about it.
Marriage, children, responsibility. I'm a writer. I made up my mind long ago. I walk a lone path.
If you change your mind, I'm the first in line. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know. Gonna be alright. You got no place to go, feeling down.
Welcome especially to Donna, who represents your family.
Dearly beloved, we gather here today.
And welcome to Sophie's dad!
What?
I have to tell you, it isn't fair to keep it from you any longer.
He is here.
I know.
What?
I invited him.
But you couldn't have, I mean, I don't know which one of them it is.
My God, that's why they're all here! Oh, Mom, will you ever forgive me?
I don't know. Will you ever forgive me?
I don't care if you slept with hundreds of men. You're my mom, and I love you.
Oh, Sophie!
I haven't slept with hundreds of men.
Hold up. Am I getting this right? Sophie may be mine, but she also may be Bill's or Harry's?
You got it! All self-righteous on me. You've only got yourself to blame.
What?
Yeah, if you hadn't gone off and married somebody else.
Yeah. No, it wasn't like that. I was engaged. I had to go back home. I thought it was the right thing to do, but I came back.
What?
I told Lorraine that I couldn't marry her, and I came right back.
Oh, why didn't you call me?
Because I was daft enough to think that you'd be sitting in your room pining for me. Only when I arrived, they told me that you were off with some other guy. I went straight back home. Lorraine told me what an idiot I was, and she married me to prove it.
If I may interrupt.
Oh, of course not. Check that. Sorry.
Stuff the check, Donna. It's yours. Look, it's fantastic to have a third of Sophie. I never even imagined I'd have that much of a child.
Harry.
Donna, you were the first girl I ever loved. But
you were also the last girl I ever loved.
Look, there's all kinds of families out there. You know what I mean? There's you and Sophie, and then there's me and Lawrence.
Well, you know, we could find out if you want to, but I agree with Harry. Being a third of your dad is great by me.
Me too.
Typical, isn't it? You wait 20 years for your dad and three show up all at once.
Well, I haven't got a clue which one of you is my real father, but I don't care. I've learned something about myself. Sky, let's not get married.
What?
We never wanted this in the first place, and we're so young. Let's just get out of this island, get out of that world.
Oh, I love you.
I love you.
Island, I've just been bursting to show you how much. Come on, Donna. Oh. It's only the rest of your life.
Darling, let's try it. You
so supportive over the past couple of years. And this weekend, it was incredible. But if we could give one last standing ovation to our senior class.
So, it's for you. Sue, in the center.